breakfast with the boys, you're having pre-match, seemed pretty relaxed. I think the boys made a point of keeping each other relaxed, you know, not getting too worked up before the game. You know, you don't want to waste all your energy before you even get out there. So just about trying to stay as calm as you can, and you know, obviously until that first whistle goes. You know, it's just game time really. Pretty normal to the end of their game. I think the biggest thing was, you know, this is your chance. This is your chance. You're here now. You know, don't have any regrets coming off the pitch, and you know, make sure you give it your all. Because obviously we knew it was a great opportunity for us, and I think the other coaches as well just wanted to get that through to you, you know, and this is a great opportunity, and don't let it pass you by. Scored, I think it was just relief. You know, it's a cup final, anything can happen. It doesn't matter who you're playing. And I think once he scored that goal, it was just a bit of relief. And you know, like I say, a buzz the whole day. But when he scored, I think it was then, don't let it slip. You know, we've got the goal. Make sure we stay switched on, and you know, do everything we can to push for another one, but also, you know, keep it tight at the back. Definitely does change the mindset. When Carlo gets sent off, it's sort of more of a mindset of just getting through it, making sure, you know, we don't concede, we've got the 1-0 lead, and just holding on to that really. Getting men behind the ball, and if we have a chance to hit them on the counter attack, then take it, because we knew what Marley was like. We knew he had the pace on the two centre halves, and he's big and strong, and you know, so it was just about getting through and hopefully not conceding really. When they scored, I thought to myself, this isn't going to be our day. But, you know, it only lasts a couple of seconds, because you have to get up and you've still got another half an hour of the game left. So you've just got to get focused again. And I think the plan was then was just to, like you say, get through. If we can get the penalties with 10 men, then so be it. But it was just about staying solid, keeping two banks of four, and like I say, having Marley on the pitch and with his speed and power, and you know, just hoping for that chance. Yeah, actually, like most people, I didn't see James Vincent make a run. I was just watching Marley, my eyes were fixed on Marley, and he's gone through, and I'm thinking, you know, with a right chance here. His shot obviously wasn't the best shot, but you know, lucky for us, Vinny was there, and you know, credit to Vinny for keeping up with Marley and you know, making that run. He came on as a sub, and he was quite fresh, you know, so for him to sort of make that run and commit himself that far forward, it was just unbelievable when he scored. I can remember Big Drapes standing beside me. And we just turned to each other and just hugged each other, fell on the floor, had a scream, back up, and then it's just back on the game again, getting through it. But definitely one of the highlights of my career, that and you know, just to share it with the team, a bunch of boys like that, was just unreal.